How can we handle feelings of spiritual disconnection when we're going through withdrawal? That's a problem that a lot of people ask me about, and that's what I'm going to address in today's video. Stay tuned, I think you'll find it useful. Hello there everyone and welcome back to The Lovely Grind. My name is Michael Preby and my website is lovelygrind.com. That's where you're going to find blog posts about health, healing, and spiritual growth. That's where you're going to find more information about my coaching and also more information about my Support and Success Monthly membership area, which has a lot of great content and a lot of great ways for you to stay encouraged and supported on your healing and wellness journey. So thanks so much for coming back to this YouTube channel, and I hope you enjoyed today's video, especially if you've been feeling a little disconnected spiritually. That's what the topic is all about. Trying to move forward, trying to feel God's presence in our life when maybe you're dealing with feelings of disconnection in general, and specifically feelings of abandonment spiritually, as if God isn't in your life, or feelings of just nothingness. Feelings of spiritual nothingness, which is something that people bring up to me. And it's a pretty common issue, really, even for people who would consider themselves to be believers, would consider themselves to be, you know, spiritually engaged in life. So how can we deal with those sorts of feelings of either being abandoned by God or just not being able to feel His wonderful presence in our lives as we're going through probably the toughest challenge of our life? Well, today I'm going to talk about a few ways that we can approach the situation so that we ultimately go closer to God rather than being pushed further away. Because there's two ways that withdrawal can push a person. It can either push you further away from God or push you closer towards God. Same could be said with some like relationships, marriages, and so forth. The withdrawal process could drive a wedge between you and your partner or bring you closer. Same could be said with even personal dreams. It can make you abandon your dreams, get pushed further away from them, or just double and triple down on pursuing your dreams and making something of yourself. But today we're talking about the spiritual aspect. And again, for those of you who don't know my story, I was on Paxil and Xanax for anxiety for more than a dozen years. And when I got off those medications, I went through a challenging withdrawal that tested me in all sorts of ways, spiritually as well. And I survived it and found healing and growth. And I'm here to talk about some of these issues related to withdrawal and healing with all of you. So what are some ways that we can make sense of feelings of spiritual disconnection and work through those feelings? Well, one important thing to remember is that feelings of disconnection, emotionally, spiritually, and otherwise, are a normal part of withdrawal and healing, right? We're all familiar with like depersonalization, derealization, anhedonia, feelings of general apathy. You know, I myself, my first stretch of months off of Paxil after so many years of daily use of that medication, it just, when I got off it, it just plummeted me into some very, very dark places and some places where it was very hard to feel any motivation, excitement, joy, to laugh, to smile. It was in the true sense anhedonia, just a general lack of interest, inability to feel pleasure, inability to feel good. And part of that would include, I guess, spiritually. Although I stayed connected, it's just tough to feel real good about basically anything for a certain period of time for some of us in withdrawal, and that's normal, okay? Feelings of connection are gonna improve. Just as the feelings of disconnection are normal, the feelings of connection, emotionally, spiritually, and otherwise, will improve organically as more time passes and more healing happens. So that's important to remember. It's also, I think, important to remember, ultimately, that we need to find ways to stay in the rhythm of spiritual activity, so to speak, even when it feels more like a chore than a rhythm, right? I mean, God's a truth, not an emotion. His presence in our life is not based on us feeling his presence per se. It's not based on us feeling good on a certain day, right? It's not based on really our opinion. It's based on the truth that we can see in nature, feel in our souls and in our intuition, and truths that we're privy to from scripture and history. So God is not an emotion, and he's not a good feeling. He is a truth. And that's important to remember, simply because we get scared thinking, well, if I can't feel him in a good way, that means he's not there. But that's not what it means. It just means we're working through a healing process where certain neurotransmitter and hormone systems are re-regulating and balancing, and we might not yet be able to feel a lot of good things, including spiritually, but that will happen. And God is still there for us while it's happening. He created our bodies and minds with the ability to make it happen if we nurture these things, to unlock those healing capabilities. I think a good way to see God's presence, even at times when we feel we've been abandoned, is to think of some of the darkest times that you've survived up until this point in the process. Think of some of the most dire times. And if you're tapering a medication or you've been off one for a while and you're going through withdrawal, no doubt you've been in some very, very touch and go dire situations physically, mentally, and emotionally, and maybe even spiritually, where you really felt tortured at the gates of hell. I know that I did. Think back to some of those times and how you survived them and how you're still here today, living, breathing, and watching this video. That's not by accident, and it's not by your own power. It's because you've been protected and guided up to this point. And just as you've been protected up to this point, you'll be moved to a further point, to further healing and greater purposes with God's continued provision and guidance in the future. So his hand has been there for you. His care has been there for you, and it's got you here, and it'll keep you moving forward. I think that another important thing to remember when we're feeling those disturbing sensations of spiritual disconnect, wondering how we can connect, wondering how we can pray, which is something a lot of people ask about. You know, how can I pray? I just either don't know how to, or I don't really feel that the things that are in my head or on my mind are prayer material. Well, I'd like to assure you that they are. You know, I think there's this great misunderstanding, especially among Christians, that there's just prayer is just some feel-good rainbows, giving thanks, you know, gratitude list sort of activity. When really, I think God just wants authenticity. Again, seeking that connection, even when we can't feel it, and when we're feeling bad, scared, angry, when we're feeling abandoned by God, cry out. Cry out to God and let him know what these feelings are. He can take it. And in fact, there's a lot of instances in the Bible of people crying out when they felt abandoned, when they felt scared, when they felt on the verge of giving up hope, giving up faith. You know, look to some of the Psalms. I just heard a statistic recently that almost a third of the Psalms, which is that big book near the middle of the Bible, almost a third of those prayers to God are complaining. Take, for example, the words of the great King David, who was described as a man after God's own heart. Take, for example, his words in Psalm 22, verses 1 and 2. He writes, "My God, why have you forsaken me? Why do you remain distant? Why do you ignore my cries for help? Every day I call to you, my God, but you do not answer. Every night you hear my voice, but I find no relief." You know, no, there's nothing sugar-coated about those words, and they're not very pleasant words, but maybe you feel like they could have come from your own head or your own mouth at times. You know, maybe he was experiencing some of the things that you felt you've been experiencing recently. Distance, depression, despair. It's okay to cry out to God with these things. You don't have to hide them. You don't have to sugarcoat them. You don't have to bottle them up. Cry out, and that's a part of seeking the sort of authentic relationship that I believe God wants with us, with our hearts. And an important thing also to remember, cry out and then declare that God is still holy and still has control over your situation and is still present for you. Those were verses 1 and 2 of Psalm 22 that I read. David goes on to write in verse 3, yet you are holy. That's how we can approach a spiritual valley with authenticity, even with anger, right? But then ultimately with reverence. David goes on to write, yet you are holy. And what follows, I think, is one idea of a prayer that we might pray when we're feeling in despair, depressed, angry, abandoned. We can pray how we feel, whatever that sounds like, in whatever language is coming to mind. And then we can say, yet you are holy, God. And I have faith that you are working on my behalf because you love me. Ultimately, your plans are better than my plans, and I know they will work for my good. So that's a way to stay connected. That's a way to be authentic, and that's a way to ultimately continue to put the situation into God's hands because he's working for our good. In the book of Matthew, Jesus has the famous invitation to us to come to him, all who are weary, because he'll offer rest. And that doesn't sound like an invitation to people who are going through just skating along, experiencing the time of their lives. The people who need rest are those who are going through things like withdrawal. You feel like you need some rest? In many respects, physically, mentally, and otherwise, you know, that sort of invitation from Jesus is a call to those who feel depressed, abandoned, in despair, disconnected. So he's calling to you. Accept that call. You know, that's a great part of my having moved through the healing process and pursuing greater contentment and fulfillment and growth afterwards, was finding that sort of peace that Jesus offers. And I know not everyone who watches my channel is Christian or even religious, but this is where I'm coming from. And hopefully you can find some words of peace in these videos, even if we're not on the exact same page. So, you know, I think take God up on that offer to become a part of his flock and have him press you to his chest, carry you when you can't walk on your own, and ultimately lead you to places that could be labeled quiet waters, still waters, peaceful places. He's there and he cares what happens to you. In 1 Peter 5:7, Peter writes, give all your worries and cares to God, for he cares what happens to you. I mean, that's a great reassurance, isn't it? Because that's what we all fear sometimes when we're going through challenging periods of grief, loss, anxiety, depression. We might wonder, does God just not care about us? Even those of us who think we're people of faith have those thoughts from time to time. But it says so right there. Peter, a man who knew Jesus personally, said, hand your worries and cares over to the Lord because he cares for you. And that's ultimately one of the greatest reassurances we can find, that on a day-to-day basis, God does care what happens to us. That doesn't mean everything is going to magically snap to the version of life that we want it to be overnight. It just means that we're not alone, we're not abandoned, and we're going to be upheld and guided forward on a path to something better. Now, one final note on this whole topic of spiritual disconnection, spiritual discontent, feelings of spiritual abandonment, and how to deal with those. We've talked about how to stay connected even when we don't. We've talked about how to cry out to God even if the language and the feelings aren't pleasant. We've talked about how to hand our situation over. We've talked about how more time is going to aid those feelings of spiritual joy and connection. And finally, I'd like to add, do things, activities, self-care activities that promote feelings of connection and spiritual connection. And I don't know what those are for you. For me, a few of those would be getting out in nature, running, exercising, and also writing, creative work. Those things allow me to feel God's presence on a more consistent basis and in more profound ways. and you're going to have your own things that help you to do that. So plan some activities into your daily and weekly routines that help to aid feelings of spiritual connection as they pertain to you. My name is Michael Preby. My website's lovelygrind.com. Again, go there to check out info about my blog posts and my mailing list and my support and success area and coaching and so forth. I hope you like this video. If you did, click thumbs up and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. I hope that you found some moments of peace in this video. And I'd like to remind you, until next time, please remember to take care of yourself and your dreams.